He was a drifter, moving from town to town, robbing a gas station here, a grocery store there, until one night. She was coming home from choir practice, but she never got there. Stauf took her purse and ran away. Then Stauf had to run and hide. He sunk even lower. He had nothing. No life, no possessions, no dreams. And that's when the vision came. A doll. And in his dream, Stauf reached out. It was a gift. Stauf carved the doll, whittling the haunting face until it was an exact replica. Stauf went to town, to a bar. The owner had a daughter. He said his girl would love the strange doll. And Stauf offered it to the man. And the owner, in turn, offered Stauf food and a place to stay. A simple transaction. The first of many. That night, Stauf had another vision. Stauf created the puzzle just as he saw it, and everyone wanted one. Stauf opened up a shop because everyone wanted a Stauf toy. Every boy and girl in the town, from all the neighboring towns. A Stauf toy is a toy for life, people said. And no two are alike. Everyone loved his unique toys. Henry Stauf grew wealthy, but then the strange virus came, and some of the children started dying. Dying, clutching their Stauf toys so close. And there was this one last vision, the last dream of a great house, a mansion the wealthy toy maker was to build. A strange house.
My, isn't this a cheery place?